This video is part one of a two-part series, and I'll be doing an example using the activity on arrow method, also known as the arrow diagramming method. And in part two, which is a separate video, I'll be doing the same example using activity on node method, also known as the precedence diagram method. So in this video, I'll be discussing the background of the activity on arrow. We'll create an activity on arrow network diagram, and then we'll do the forward path and backward path on the activity on arrow network diagram. In part two, which is a separate video, we will create an activity on node network diagram using the same example, and then we'll do the forward path and backward path on the activity on node network diagram. So historically, two methods were developed to do the project schedule network diagram, which is the arrow diagramming method, also known as activity on arrow, and then the precedence diagram method, also known as the activity on node. So for the activity on arrow, the activity is represented by arrow, and the activities are then linked together with nodes. And then for the activity on node, the activity is represented by a rectangle or square box, and they are linked together with arrows. And the arrows represents the different dependencies, which is the finish to start, finish to finish, start to start, and start to finish. And it is important to remember that for the activity on arrow, we only use the finish to start dependency. So over time, the precedence diagram method became the preferred method, and that is most often used. So the main elements of your activity on arrow is your arrow, and we indicate the activity name and the activity duration, and then the activities are linked with nodes, and on the node we normally indicate the start time, the finish time of the node, and then the finish minus start we use to calculate our total float and slack. And in some instances, we can also use a node, which is divided into four segments, where we also indicate the node number. Now, the activity on arrow can require the use of a dummy activity, and the dummy activity is represented by a dashed line that normally has no name or duration. So in this example, we can see that activity D is connected to B, and activity D is connected with a dummy activity to activity A. So we use the forward pass and backward pass to calculate our project duration, our total float, and the critical path of the project. Now the critical path is activities on the longest path, which determines the shortest duration of the project. So let's have a look at a small example to explain the forward pass and backward pass. So we've got the start node, where activity A and B is connected to start. Activity A and activity B is connected to start. Activity C is connected to A, and activity D is connected to B, and D is connected to A with a dummy activity. The duration of A is 1 day, of B is 3 days, of C is 6 days, and of D is 7 days. So if we do the forward pass, we start off with the start of 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. Then we've got 0 plus 3 is 3, or 1. And the forward pass, we use the highest start, so that's going to be 3. 1 plus 6 is 7, and 3 plus 7 is 10. We use the highest start, which is 10, which indicates that our project duration is 10 days. So when we do the backward path, we start with 10. 10 minus 7 is 3. 10 minus 6 is 4, or 3. We use the lowest finish, which is 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 3 is 0. The lowest finish is 0. And then to calculate our total float, it's the finish minus start, which is 0. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 3 is 0. And 10 minus 10 is 0. And our critical path is where the total float is 0. So that's going to be start, activity B, D, and finish. So let's do our main example. We're going to start with our start node. Activity A, B, and C is connected to start. So that's going to be activity A, activity B, and activity C, which is connected to start. Activity D is connected to activity A. So D is connected to activity A. E is connected to activity B. And then we've got F that connects to activity E and to activity C. So F is connected to E, and F is connected to C with our dummy activity. And G is connected to D. D is connected to G, and G is connected to E with a dummy activity. And then G and F is connected to the end node. The duration of A is 1 day. Duration of B is 3 days. Of C is 5 days. Of D is 6 days. Of E is 7 days. F is 3 days. And G is 5 days. So when we do the forward pass and backwards pass, again, we start with a duration of 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 3 is 3. 0 plus 5 is 5. Then 3 plus 7 is 10, or 5. We use our higher start, which is 10. 1 plus 6 is 7, or 10. We use 10, which is our higher start. 10 plus 5 is 15, and 10 plus 3 is 13. We use our higher start, so that's 15, and our project duration is 15 days. So when we do our backward pass, we start with finish of 15. 15 minus 5 is 10. 15 minus 3 is 12, or 10. We use our lowest finish when we do our backward pass, so that's 10. 10 minus 6 is 4. 10 minus 7 is 3. And 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. 10 minus 3 is 0. 4 minus 1 is 3. Our lowest finish, that is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0. And then to calculate our total float, 0 minus finish minus start, 0 minus 0 is 0. 4 minus 1 is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. 10 minus 5 is 5. 10 minus 10 is 0. 10 minus 10 is 0. And 15 minus 15 is 0. So our critical path is where the total float is 0. And the activities on the critical path is our start, activity B, E, G, and finish. I hope this video helped you to understand the activity on arrow method. And the next video is part 2 of the series. We will use the same example to develop the activity on node network diagram. If you like this video, you can give me a thumbs up. And if you are interested in future videos, you're welcome to subscribe.